next session at Brookline Tai Chi, we're going to be starting a new round of Marriage of Heaven and Earth Qigong, what I was just showing you. And what I want you to know about Heaven and Earth is that there are kind of two big levels, at least for me, from where I can teach it from and the level that I see it from. There are two big levels that you can work on with this practice. The first, in what I just showed you, the obvious thing about it is the body is doing this. And what we do when we train Heaven and Earth is we get all the joints to do that. So the joints open and close. So from a physical point of view, you're going to loosen up your body. Right? No more stiff joints, which is pretty awesome. But I want to talk a little bit about the benefits for the mind of doing that. See, initially, when most people start doing Tai Chi, they're attracted to the slow motion movement of the form. Right? And what the slow motion choreography does is it takes your mind racing at a million miles an hour, and it teaches your body to go really slowly. And eventually, you kind of find a synchronized rhythm between the mind and the body that essentially, the slow physical movements get the mind to slow down and move at a much more even pace. And that slowing down is huge for stemming some of this burnout that we get, mental burnout. And eventually you slow it down to a pace where a lot of the sort of natural restorative mechanisms that you're overriding can kick back in. So that's what's so rejuvenating about Tai Chi initially, is the slow motion stuff. But see, Heaven and Earth is situated between the basic practices like that and the more advanced stuff. And the reason why it's a bridge between basic to more advanced is because it takes the way your body and your mind interface and brings it to a whole different level. And it does it through this mechanism, right? You talk about the physical benefits of opening and closing the joints. What you start to have to pay attention to are literally the hydraulics in the body, the fluid movements. And the way the fluids move inside the body is not linear. It's very circular. So you get into this circular thing where you've got open, turning into close, turning into open, and the quality of mind this demands, or that you develop by listening for those fluid circular transitions, is completely different. Instead of thinking about concentrating on something, tensing up when you go to focus and concentrate, what you do is you learn to listen and land your mind on this stuff. Really subtle stuff at first, and it's frustrating, it's hard, it doesn't map on to the way we're used to interfacing with the body. But when you learn it, right, you learn how to apply a quality of mind that tracks and listens and follows and contains without tensing up. So you're present to these internal flows, and you can stay with them, you can have your mind on something, but it's a more diffuse, a broader, a more encompassing quality of mind. And I know that sounds kind of weird. So if that sounds way too far out, just know that your joints aren't going to feel stiff anymore if you do have it hurt. But the possibility that you can actually train your mind to work in a different way, in a more relaxed, more diffuse, more sort of enveloping kind of way, is pretty cool. And we'll talk at some point about all the other benefits that go along with adopting and developing that quality of mind. So to me, that's those are the two big benefits, and kind of the exciting payoff of this Qigong set is that it starts to put you into that territory where you're actually changing how your focus and your awareness is used.